Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I deeply appreciate the recognition. All of us spent last week in our home states with the people we work for. And their message was clear. They're fed up. They're not happy with what we're doing here. Lost faith that Congress can work for them. So our chance here is to begin restoring some of that lost faith. The Farm Bill is about jobs. Between prices and weather, producers already face enough unpredictability. They want more certainty, and we're here to deliver it. Tomorrow, Montana volunteers will deliver their first shipment of heifers to South Dakota ranchers wiped out by the recent storm. I'm proud of that generosity, but they shouldn't have to do it alone. Restoring livestock disaster assistance permanently is critical, and it's one of the many areas, I think, where we all agree. Still, our differences are stark. The House proposed farm programs won't work for Montana. Montana farmers will be faced with the difficulty of guessing future prices and yields in order to choose between two programs that address very different kinds of risk. And neither of these programs would be effective because a farm-level option is essential in large counties, which we have, where one farmer could get held out while another has a record year. Tying target prices to planted acres runs the risk of undermining decades of reform by influencing planting, very important decisions made across the country. And we must carefully consider how best to honor our international trade obligations. American producers depend on the opportunities that trade creates. There are many areas beyond Title I where we need to find agreement. More than 70% of SNAP households in Montana have children. In the richest country on earth, there's no excuse for kids to go hungry. We need a solution that doesn't hurt folks who need the help the most. Timber jobs depend on a strong forest conservation program and tools to manage beetle-killed trees. We have distinct priorities. I'm going to stand up and fight for those in Montana, just as I expect all the rest of us to fight for the priorities in their home states. But if we listen more than we talk, we can produce a bill everyone can proudly support. This is my sixth farm bill. I'm determined to leave Montanans and our country with the certainty they can count on. Success depends on working together. Our nation is watching. Let's show people that Congress can work for them. And I might say, Mr. Chairman, I can remember the 2008 Farm Bill. It was a wonderful conference. Wonderful, you'll recall. We sat there, bipartisan, bicameral, around the tables, and we learned a lot about agriculture in different parts of the country. I learned a lot about avocados, about apples, about peanuts and cotton and so forth. And a lot of folks learned a lot about hard red winter wheat. And it is a very, very good session. We listened. We found trade-offs. We helped each other out in the best sense of the term. It was compromise. I must say, too, I'm reminded of the celebration yesterday of Speaker Tom Foley. Tom Foley was one of the most wonderful persons I've had the privilege to ever know. I don't know anyone with more integrity, more intelligence, more grace, more decency, more hardworking than Tom. And the hallmark, too, was compromise. Tom Foley was a public servant in the best sense of the term. He cared about the 5th District in Washington, but he really cared about finding solutions. And I urge all of us to just remember Speaker Tom Foley and remember what we can do here, and also remember that people are really fed up with us. And we have an opportunity here to do something that makes some sense, and that's why we're here in the first place. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.